We have seen how to write down one cubit. But how about many cubits? Classically, if we have n bits, we can write this down as a string of numbers x1 up to xn. So in total, there is 2 to the n possible strings. We can now proceed just as before, where we associate a vector with every possible classical string. And how we'll do this is that we will make the vector 0 everywhere except at the position indexed by x. There are 2 to the n possible strings, so we can think of x as a number between 1 and 2 to the n. Let's go back to the case of one qubit. Here, n is 1, and 0 was the vector where I had a 1 in the first position and a 0 in the second one, and 1 had a 0 in the first position and a 1 in the second one. Now that we can write down classical strings as vectors, we can again consider a superposition of these vectors. So we can write the state of n qubits as a vector, namely this one, whose coefficients are alpha x. These alphas are again complex numbers, and we will again make the demand that the vector has length 1. This means that the inner product is 1, or equivalently that the sum of the amplitudes alpha squared gives us 1. To summarize, the state of n qubits is nothing else than a vector in CD, a complex vector space of dimension D, where the dimension is 2 to the n, n being the number of qubits, and it has length 1. Let's have a look at some examples. For 2 qubits, we have n equals 2, and we have 4 possible classical strings, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. With each of these, we will associate a vector. These 4 vectors, which define the standard basis. Look what we've done here. We have numbered the strings, and we have put a 1 at the position corresponding to that string. Now we have the classical basis, the standard basis. And I can now take the superposition of these vectors. One example would be an equal superposition. So my state of 2 qubits looks like half, 0, 0, plus half, 0, 1, plus half, 1, 0, plus half, 1, 1. To be absolutely clear, if I write this out, I have half times 1, 0, 0, 0, plus half, 0, 1, 0, 0, plus half, 0, 0, 1, 0 plus half 0, 0, 0, 1. So if I sum them all up, I get half times 1, 1, 1, 1. You should check that if I take the inner product between of this vector, the vector has length 1, so this is a valid 2-qubit quantum state. Let's now consider another 2-qubit state written in the same standard basis. This state is so famous, and we'll use it quite a lot, that it has a special name. Namely, it's called the EPR pair. EPR stands for Einstein, Podolsky and Rosen. I'll also denote this state as EPR. We will later see that this state is entangled. It is superposition between 0, 0 and 1, 1. And we have to normalize this to make sure that the vector has length 1. So again, if I write this as a vector, I have 1 over square root 2. From the 0, 0, I have 1, 0, 0, 0. From 1, 1, remember there we had just a 1 at the end. I get 0 everywhere except at the last position. And if I sum them all up, I have 1 over square root 2 times 1, 0, 0, 1. Let's check that this vector has length 1, so it's a valid quantum state. To do this, we compute the inner product with psi and itself. And I'll do this in a slightly different way now, so you can see there's a few ways of getting there. Instead of taking this and flipping it on its side, I will work directly with this Ketbra notation up here. So I'll write 1 over square root 2, and I'll turn the elements into bras. So we have the inner product of this times the original vector. So let me do that. So from the 1 over square root of 2, I have this 2 times, I get a half. And now we have all the different combinations. So we have 0, 0 with 0, 0. I'll get 0, 0 with 1, 1. I'll get 1, 1 with 0, 0. And finally 1, 1, 1, 1. So remember that the elements of the standard basis are orthogonal. This means that this term is 0 and this term is 1, also 0. So let's remember that these vectors are also normalized, meaning that the length of this vector is 1 and the length here is also 1. So if I add them up, I have a half. 1 plus 1, which gives me 1. So we see that it's a valid qubit. Let's consider a final example of 2 qubits in a state, which looks like 0, 1, 1, 1. So the second qubit is always a 1. This example is quite different than the previous one. We will later see that this state is not entangled. So if I write this as a vector, we have 0, 1, 0, 0. And remember that this again has a 1 in the last position, giving us 1 over square root 2, 0, 1, 0, 1. I leave it for you to check that this is normalized, so you should be computing the inner product of the state. Now you know how to write a state of n qubits.